Hello fellas, I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today you are going to see two games, one with Patton and another with a standard B. We are trying to come back on track and listen, I want to show you something new. What do I mean? Have you ever seen the dragon which is not working properly? Look at this. Okay, let's focus on the bad. Anyways, we have a Patton game, tier 10 Patton game. Battle is on the life oaks, three sky shits, which is not very, very nice, but not much what we can do about this. But in the same time, pay attention how many tank destroyers enemies has. And how many heavies. What we can predict immediately from this setup, they are going to play in the city and tank destroyers. More likely they are going to camp around this area, around this area, around this area. So we should have a clear way right there. And even though we don't have too many forces right there, I was getting quite close to get mark of excellence on this tank. So at first I was not thinking about making a hardcore pressure, but after some time we are going to change our mind. As you can see, 140 went in front, and what he spotted? He spotted AMX and he spotted 1-to-1. I want to give him a bit more time and pay attention what happened right there. Both of those guys retreated. What that basically means, we can push in front aggressively, and you can repeat the same thing if you are seeing if you are paying attention at the enemy setup and everything, right? In this situation, I just saw I can make a pressure right there because enemy forces are not there, and we can punish them for their stupidity, if I can say so, right? Anyways, first of all, we are peeking out there, right? And we see this scout over there. Oh boy, you made a huge mistake, Mr. Scout. And what do we want to do? We want to eliminate him from the game before it's too late. Yeah, I know, artists and everything. Now look, let's stop everything right there. First of all, what can you do? What kind of options do you have? Option number one is to go in front aggressiver against 1-to-1 and get bombed by the artists and by the tank destroyers. Option number two, to get some balls and to make a scout run like this. What this kind of scout run is giving to you? Everything. Literally everything. First of all, this AMX made a mistake, he is down, and now we want to go in front. Why? Because we are going to provide our team with assisting damage, and as you can see, I'm pinging on the map, I'm pinging for those sniper schnitzels over there, for TIE 5 heavy sniper schnitzel, Grille 15, Fava, even RHM, I'm pinging them to pay attention what we are doing, and we are crossing through this side, and from here we can spot snipers over there, over there, over there. Basically we can see everything. And now look, oh Mr. Bobject, how are you? And right there our risk is going to pay off, because they cannot do anything too much for us. I am pretty much safe. I am spotting them, and any fart from their side is going to lead to the garage. And this Grille, nothing. He is dead meat. Bobject still over there, but I don't mind. I am feeling very, very well with it. And Bobject just died too. So far, it's very good start. We have 4,000 in 3 minutes of the game, if we can say so. But we are only starting right there. Pay attention. Batshit spotted over there. We can have a shot on the Batshit. He's trying to escape. Okay, fair enough. He took one for the team. Now we are spotting the clicker which is leaving. And fellas, when you are taking this position, There is a couple of things what you can do. You can clear this area over there while being here, and then you can peek here so you can see people which is sniping from this position over there. I thought it's going to be way better to go over there, and there is a couple of options what you can do. For example, do you see that Grille? He's going to disappear in a second or so, right? Because we have some snipers in the back and they are just going to eat him. Well, Grille survived for surprisingly a long time, but now it's game over for this guy. Anyways, I am trying to pay attention at everything while I'm in this situation, while I am in this position, like literally everything. Jack Pizda, we can't reach him. Arta, hello Arta, unfortunately I did not manage to hit the no aim shot, and this tank is very, very good at it. Now we are hitting the trash barn, dead star in side of the turret. And this is pretty much game over for this guy, right? I'm trying to hit his cupola, but it's not working that well. But hey, we are just starting our journey. Obviously, RNG is saying, no, 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 no. Skill, you are not going to hit him. But in the same time, we are getting the sweet assisting damage, so I'm not complaining. Pay attention right here. We have 8,200 and there is still a lot of meat left. For example, TIE 5 heavy. Oh, you lovely TIE 5 heavy. Obviously, all we need to do in this situation is just to clean enemies up. And what we did right there, it was perfect. It was close to perfection, if we can say so. We reacted in time to push towards this side over there. We cleared all this area here, obviously with our team help. That's why we have plenty of damage and assisting damage, and that was just ideal battle. So what is my tips for every single of you which is playing this map from this side? If you have a chance, if you have enough forces, try to go over there. If you are winning this side, repush like this, and by any means don't go like this, because it's just simply way too dangerous and it's quite bad. By the way, I'm getting 1,500 tracking damage in the end, which is not very good for Mark of Excellence, but for General Scholar, it's looking more spicy. So speaking of marks, we are getting over 10,000 assisting damage, over 10,000 combined, and there is still a TIE 5 heavy left, which we are going to claim. Obviously, fellas, by any means, we are shooting gold for a TIE 5 heavy, and I believe it's completely understandable, right? Since it is a TIE 5, right? But other than that, this battle was very, very beautiful. So 11,500 damage for marks, and in general, we have 13,000 combined, which is solid banana out of 10. So yeah, fellas, let's go for other replay, right? Let's go. And in this second game, we have perfect case scenario. I am top tier against the enemy tier 7s. Obviously, there is quite some tier 9 tanks too, but let's get real. This is the situation where you are thinking, oh, boy, that's what everyone is thinking right here. So, what can we do? This map is called Murovanka. In my opinion, it's one of the better maps in the game. And I'm just enjoying playing it. Speaking of the north side, I love forest and I love the Echo 7 position. It's just golden. It is just beautiful. And it's just solid banana out of 10. So I'm heading there because you can cover the forest. You can pretty much shoot everywhere you want to, apart the one line, right? But other than that, it's just beautiful. So look, what we are doing right here, we are taking this beautiful, beautiful position over there, and we are just relying on the enemy mistakes. For example, this T-49 is trying to cross. I missed the shot. Well, that was my fault. And right there, since there is two clickers, I'm just trying to escape before it's too late. Anyways, yeah, not the best start, only one shot from the clipper, but it's just a start. And this T49 is very, very brave. You know what is happening with a for a brave T49s? They are not living forever, that's for sure. And remember what I have said now, this T49 is going to be eliminated eventually. Anyways, I am trying to be safe right here, I'm trying to dodge, I'm trying to wiggle because of the artist, and I'm trying to be the most unpredictable as possible. And right here, I am taking this bush in front of the TIE-59, and I kind of messed up right here. I wasted quite some time right here. I'm going to pick the double X speed until I will notice that, because what was my initial thoughts right there, I was thinking this TIE-59, eventually he will go and we are going to kill him, but unfortunately it's not the case. I was thinking maybe he's going to go for a blind shot or something, but he's just trying to get himself a better position right there, and it's I'm wasting my time right here instead of helping the team, which is not very good, and I must admit my responsibility right here. It was just not the best gameplay, but I noticed that now, and I'm saying no. It's just not good. I am wasting too much time while doing nothing. 2 minutes, 3 minutes in only 600 damage dealt, and I'm top tier. I should carry some weight right there. But in the same time, standard B fellas is extremely hard tank to play with, and any mistake you are going to make, it's going to be crucial for you, I'm telling you. And the same TIE-59, which I was waiting patiently in that position, now he's going in. Look, one for the team, two TIE-59, two for the team for 59, the same T-49 blah, 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 traveling around there, and look at this awkward situation right there. My friend, my teammate T-44, he is blocking pretty much everything, and I can't risk to shoot this because I might kill my ally. And I know it's maybe it was not looking that bad now, but believe me, it was very, very risky. This guy's taking one for the team. A TIE-59 is dead, T-49 is tracked, and T-34 went in front. And right there, I see we have pretty much no forces left over there, but I'm still waiting to get couple of shots because this tank is like Ferrari. It has speed, so to escape like this, it's very, very easy and it's very simple. Until we have someone which is going to do quality spots, we can help them. And look, Batchet tracked, and Batchet is taking one for the team. And now I'm thinking I had enough of this, and it's simply not worth it. So far, 3000 damage dealt. Okay, we are getting there. Everything is looking tiny touch better, right, fellas? And our Sue and this guy over there, they are going to hold this flank at least for a bit. T-49, blah, 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 blah. He went in front, and our Sue said, so he died. Well, but it's understandable, right? So this battle was not perfect by any means, but it was not a bad game, and the end result is going to be very, very sweet. And I played quite safe. Right there, for example, look, I could shoot this guy twice and I could eliminate him from the game, but I didn't do that. I was waiting till I will have one more, and that waiting was definitely not very good by me. I simply could eliminate this person, but in the same time, I'm not complaining too much. Now I am in this situation, fellas. I'm just waiting till the Tiger 1 will peek, right? And right there, I'm trying to go with a blind shot, and I want to figure out this guy is peeking or this guy is not peeking. Very hard to say something, but that was not a hit, right? And I am just looking to the other side, looking for some fallen objects or crushed cars or trees or whatever, and I'm just trying, right? That was such a waste, but shit happens. Now, Let's check who is not spotted from the enemy team. Scorpion G not spotted, Rev not spotted, and Stunner Emil is not spotted, right? Obviously Clicker. So three guys is not spotted. And I am thinking they should have Scorpion around this area. Why am I thinking that? Because those bushes over there, they are extremely powerful, and it's understandable, right? It's just beautiful position for a tank destroyer. And I am looking into this area, and I'm thinking, yeah, I need to blind fire here. And look, Scorpion out of nowhere is getting spotted. Too bad I did not have 3 in the magazine, but 2 is more than enough. Why? And that's why, fellas, Clicker just sent him to death or to the garage. So far, 4.4 done, very, very nice. And now we are waiting till we are going to have a full clip, then we will figure out what do we want to do. And right here, I'm just trying to aim for some blind shots, like typical positions of the tank destroyers. For example, this hotel one slash golf one position, it's very good. And maybe Stunner Emil could sit here. But as you can see, he is not there, and my blind shot was kind of waste. And if you are wondering why I'm not making a pressure in this kind of situation, is very, very simple. You see those two brown shits? You see those people over there which can have a crossfire on me? It's not worth it. It's way too risky. And sometimes it's better to play safe than to be sorry after that. Right here, I am checking, S1 is spotting me? This is the main question, and oh boy, S1 is just going in front. Beautiful. 2 shots into the S1, and unfortunately, but our clickers, he had other things to do, and they was fapping on the Stunner Emil, which is completely understandable. I will help for our artist with semi-snapshot, and he is dead. And right here, now we know pretty much where everyone is, apart the Rev. But Rev is going to surprise us in the end of the game, so all good. Right here, I am just going for this S1. I think I just need to deal with him. And by the way, this camo is quite sexy, don't you think so? Oh yes, indeed it is. One for the team, and he is dying for our Borshik, which is sitting next to us in the Charlie 1. Art is hitting us for 330, and when I'm saying I'm paranoid by the Arta, I completely mean it, fellas. I am paranoid by Arta, so that's why I'm not making too much pressure with a tank which can be penetrated and which do not have like very good armor. Look what is my plan over there. My plan over there is to take the Charlie 1 position myself, and maybe I can outspot this this on E. I'm going to put a turbo speed right there, so twice faster, because it's not going to be the case, but it's worth a thing mentioning, right? I think it's just, it was not a bad idea by any means, because if that person would be on that side, he would be dead. But in the same time, you know, it was not the case, but I can mention that, right? Our Su 130PM is defending that position very, very well. And now, since only 4 guys is left, Rev, Oni, and 2 clickers. By the way, speaking of Rev, he never ever was spotted in this game. Oh, there he is. Well, as you can see, Rev is getting spotted, and now I'm just fully clipping him. Why? Because we have 2 artists. You know what 2 artists is going to do? 2 artists is going to rain on this guy, and he is going to die. Artists will rain on the guy, and he will die. Artists! I mean, if Arta is not going to kill him in the next 3 seconds, I will take his life. Too late, Arta. And I'm not feeling bad. I gave quite some time for Clicker to deal with this guy, right? Anyways, 7000 damage, 700 assisting damage, very very nice. Oni and two clickers left, easy game for us. I am missing one thing to do, and you know what is that one thing? To rig brother in arms with our clicker. By the way, if you have 3 kills, fellas, feel free to invite whatever teammate into platoon, and you will get free brother in arms medal. So that basically means you are going to be brothers forever and ever. Think about it. And right there, we just eliminated this Arta, and now while searching for the other one, I was trusting my gut he is going to do over there. As you can see, I did not even check at the kilo zero position, and yeah. In the end of the day, that was a good game. Even though I made quite some mistakes, like in the forest I wasted some time, I did not kill the Tiger 1 immediately. I mean, we cannot say that was shitty ass game or something. 7.7, 800, over 8000 combined skill is happy. Quick update about the health, fellas. I'm still feeling like a shit, as you can see from my nose. No, I'm not magician. I cannot stop this this side from breathing. No, I'm not magician. So I'm not feeling too well. So I'm not streaming, because to do a YouTube video and to focus like 30 minutes is one thing, and to focus 7, 6, 5 hours to stream, it's other things. So please understand me, but my health for now is saying brrr, and I cannot do that. But I believe you can understand me, and everything is fine. For tomorrow, I believe from now on we are going to go back to the normal schedule, and we are going to have one video each every day, and everything is fine. So thank you so much for watching, fellas. I hope I made you smile and you laugh at quite a bit. If yes, I did the job correctly. If I gave you one or another tip in the game, I did everything correctly. And if you learn a new way to speak English properly, I did my job. So thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Skill is out. Peace, fellas.